Are you considering an early withdrawal from your IRA? Well, perhaps you've run into a financial hardship, and this seems like the only way that you can get money to meet your needs. Now, if you are under age 59 and a half, this could result in potentially giving you income taxes and an additional 10% early withdrawal penalty. Now, there are exceptions to taking money out and paying a penalty. One of these involves substantially equal periodic payments from an IRA. So the IRS has several safe harbor methods for calculating these types of distributions. They include required minimum distribution method, the amortization method, and the annuitization method. Now, all these methods require that you use a life expectancy or mortality table to calculate how much money will need to come out. Now, payments must be taken at least annually and are either fixed or recalculated annually depending on the method that you choose. Now, you'll have to be taking these payments for a minimum of 5 years or age 59 and a half, whichever is longer. Now, this could mean that you could be taking payments for a long period of time. So if you needed to take money out at age 45, for instance, you have to take monies until age 59 and a half, which is over 14 and a half years. Now, given this, you may want to look at other sources of income. Maybe you're about to receive Social Security at the age of 62, and that could help offset some of the income that you need. Maybe your company offers a pension that you can start taking money at age 60. Now, you also are going to want to take the amount that you need. So if your IRA is larger and the amount that you need to take out based upon one of the three calculations is more than you need, there is a way of avoiding this. You can roll part of the IRA over into another IRA, leaving the amount necessary so that you can take only the withdrawals that you need, leaving the rest of the IRA intact, growing deferred. Now, be careful when you do this. If you do a rollover from one IRA to another and you take the check, you've got 60 days to put it into another IRA, you can only do this once a year. I'm going to recommend here that you use a trustee-to-trustee direct IRA-to-IRA transfer. Now, once you start receiving these distributions from a particular IRA, you're not allowed to transfer money into or take additional distributions out of it. Now, at the end of the period, you can modify what you take out of it. You can stop, but don't forget, once you reach age 70 and a half, you still have to take those required minimum distributions. There's a lot of information here out there, and you can receive some information online at the irs.gov website, publication 590. And because this is fairly complex, it's also a good thing to talk with your tax advisor before going ahead.